president of the United Domestic Workers Union in the Philippines. Philippines is the second country which ratified Convention 189. So let us hear what changes it has brought to the domestic workers in the Philippines and also what are the challenges.
Yes.
Novi?
Okay, formation of domestic workers organization in Asia. Most countries do not recognize domestic workers as workers. They are excluded from the labor law, so they are not able to form their union and get registered. Despite this, with the Convention 189, domestic workers still form their own organization no matter registry or not. They have more voice. Convention 189 ratification only in Asia, in the Philippines. We have domestic workers law, but still we are fighting for the minimum wage, social protection, and the registration, and also the contract of the domestic worker. It is still very hard to get more Asian countries to ratify Convention 189. However, we continue to fight. Bangladesh, Cambodia, and Thailand established domestic workers regularization policies, but they are not legally binding, not implemented, and limited. Because of our affiliates' activism, our affiliates in Hong Kong, the Progressive Labor Union, is able to push government to impose more monitoring of employment agencies. In India, affiliates able to assert minimum wage for domestic workers in 14 states. In Nepal, in 2017, domestic workers are finally recognized as workers in the labor law. Convention 189 has not been much real changes in laws and policies in Asia. It is IDWF, its affiliates, domestic workers themselves who are actively making use of Convention 189 to lobby governments. Most important of all, we have more domestic workers leaders actively doing reaching out and organize domestic workers. That's all. Thank you.